Deputy Mayor, would you do me one favor?
Sure.
In about 30 seconds, would you explain what it is we are doing for the Inesto?
Urban redevelopment TIF, I'll try to put it in the simplest terms. There's going to be an evaluation for the property. And that valuation from where it is now to when the auditor makes a determination, we're trying to position ourselves to capture that increase in tax value. Can you follow me?
Can you expand a little bit on that?
Okay, so with a TIF, let's just say today is valued at $100,000. The treasurer is going to make a determination very soon on the valuation of that property based on the improvements that have been made. Let's say that it goes up to $1 million. So that's a significant difference. We're trying to capture from where it is now to where it will be when that determination is made. Okay, so that's the tax increment financing portion. What we're attempting to do is reimburse the developer. He will pay 75% of those taxes. They'll be reimbursed to him over a 10-year period.
It's really no different than what we do for many businesses, giving them tax breaks to bring in more employees.
It's different than a tax abatement, but
no,
it's really...
I understand that, but ultimately the result is pretty much the same.
We attempt to incentivize businesses to invest in our community, yes.
So if we believe in this project, which I think we unanimously did, despite some people feeling queasy about it, nevertheless, the end result is going to be to protect our investment,
right,
to give the developer a break, so he's not just pounded by an improvement tax.
Right.
And it's similar to what we do for any business in our community that we want to keep, maintain, and help build more jobs for the community.
I mean, that's absolutely correct. And again, I know I keep referring back to the Huntington Bank building. It's a separate project, but it is really relevant. And some of you may be aware of this, but when Miramar Realty purchased the building, I want to say it was valued about $3.1 million. When the purchase was made, the valuation went up to about $8.8 million, and the taxes went up 180%. And remember, Mac isn't here, but him and I have been working diligently to make sure that the tenants that are in that building doesn't incur that 180%, and that's exactly what's happening. We have some tenants in that building now. One accounting firm is already gone. And Huntington Bank used to have three floors, they're down to two. We have some other firms that are looking to go to Jackson Township because the developer had no idea the taxes were going to go up like that, so he's passing it on to the tenants. And you know, here's a situation where I wish we could offer some kind of incentive, but we can't at this time. So, you know, it was great that a developer bought this building, but we're about to lose some high-paying jobs as a result, because we can't incentivize it.